This video is how to make a tiny calla lily. To make these tiny lilies, I started with pearl clay, turquoise clay, and a piece of the new opal clay. The lilies are made of a Skinner blend. And I make it just like we always do with the Skinner blend, sort of. Pearl seems to have a lot of translucent in it, so when I use it, I try to remember that it will be overwhelmed by the darker color. So a lot of times I just take a little bit out of the darker color in the middle here and push that up in there. And kind of make that square we always kind of see in a Skinner blend. When working on these very, very small amounts, I will use a thinner number. I don't do it, pass it through at the widest on my pasta machine. I kind of go to the middle because it's a very small piece of clay. This is what the clay looks like after 16 passes through the pasta machine. I took this piece of opal that I have here and I put it through on a number 8, where number 9 is the thinnest on a machine. This super thin piece of opal will now go right on top of the Skinner blend. By doing it this way, the opal will mix into both colors evenly. After 5 passes through the pasta machine on the medium setting, the opal now is mixed beautifully into all of the parts of the clay. We're going to make a block to cut each petal from. Let's start at this edge and just begin rolling the clay up. I want to roll it up tightly so that it doesn't catch any air. I don't want a lot of air bubbles in here. I'm going to roll it gently now to secure it. To make it longer, I would roll and pull my hands apart, but I want this shorter, so I'm going to roll it and push my hands together. And you'll notice that it's getting fatter in the middle, so I want to stop it from getting fat in the middle and make it be fat on the end. I'll put my finger on the end, press it gently, and then I'll move my finger as I roll towards my finger. I don't want to squeeze it because it could mushroom over on itself, and that isn't pretty. And you'll see now this end is as big as that one at the center, so I'm going to start on the other end. And I'll press it gently to get us started and then roll towards the center. Turn it around again and continue to roll. I want this to be about half an inch this way. Just keep going. And now we've kind of reached a point where we can start to manipulate the clay by pinching it gently. And this is called a plug. It's round, and I want to make it square. That would be a loaf. So I'm going to pinch here, pinch the sides, and then press in here this direction and pinch the sides. I want to keep the pearly end pearl color. You just keep working out with it, your hands, pinching it until it begins to turn into a square. And now that it's fairly square shape, I need it to be longer this way. I want to have a kind of a sheet of the clay here that's white on this side and blue on this side. I've got a little bit of blue up there in my white color. I'm just going to take that off. Now you might be wondering, why would we do this? And it's because instead of rolling the clay out and cutting out a pattern, what we're going to do here is we're actually make this piece of clay the shape of a calla lily pattern. So now that it's gotten to be about that big, which is good, the next thing I want to do is make the calla lily shape out of this piece of clay. First of all, calla lilies are pointy at the top, like that. So I'm going to make this little block be pointy by pinching it and pulling it up. Do you see that? How it's now pinchy at the top? It's pinchy and pointy. I'm going to press down now to shape the body of the lily. And now what we have is this really cool shape here. It's small, and this means that every single piece I cut from this stick of clay can be shaped into a calla lily. I'm going to set that aside now and condition the yellow. I have here a small piece of yellow clay. It doesn't have to be very big to make the tiny little flower petals in, or the stems in there. A calla lily is actually a leaf formed around a little stick of tiny, tiny blossoms. I'm going to roll this out. I don't need a lot for each little lily. And I'll set that aside. For a project as small as this, I use a razor blade, and I'm going to cut one slice. And the opal in here makes the slices a bit messy because it's hard to cut through the opal flakes, but they're really pretty. To size the thickness of what I want, before I cut, I will actually lay the blade down and see how much clay I'll be cutting off, stand that up, and rock it down. I'll cut a couple of these. And you can see the tiny opal flakes, but that's no problem. I'm going to take this piece of clay, and I'm going to put right here at the top, I'm going to give it a good pinch there, and a little bit, pull it together a bit at the bottom, and shape it like this. Just lift it using a blade. Don't need a sharp blade for lifting. And then I take the tool. I've got this little tool that comes in my kit, toolkit, but you can use any kind of pointy shape, because all we're going to do is hold it and just pull these two edges together like this and press. I'm not pinching hard, just using that to press. I'll grab it now, twist gently, and remove it. I'll pinch the edges gently to flare them. Pinch the tip here, and then push a little bit like that to open it up. Now take a small piece of the yellow. And slide it right into the lily and touch it right about there. Holding it with one hand, gently, very gently at the tip, I'm going to pinch this bottom like this, pinch, pinch, and what I'm doing is forming the base, and then I'll do a little twirl like that, and I've got a stem. This remaining piece of clay will make at least 8 more to 10 lilies. I like to finish the lilies by bringing out the pearly colors using mackerel pearl, and this is called brilliant gold. I chose this because it's a light gold. If you wanted to embellish the dark part of the lily, I picked up the turquoise for that. I take a small brush, very small little brush, and dip it in the mackerel pearl and knock off the excess. And then I like to take it and just stroke every part of it that still you can see the white pearl on. On the inside, on either side of the little yellow one spot, and on all the edges. I think the edges are highlighted by doing that. And just for fun, and since a lot of times I use these for earrings or dangles, I also do the white part on the back and make it very pearly. The next step after this is to use the gold color next and paint the little yellow clay in the center. This gives a nice effect. Lastly, if you wish, you can use the turquoise and darken and metallicize the turquoise color. Thanks for stopping by.